I'm Joan Johnson, a 40-year member of South Church, and happy to be participating in this 21-day challenge. The subject I'm exploring is poetry written by Black women so that I may gain a glimmer of understanding of their life experience and thoughtful reflections. The two poets that I've chosen are pictured here, Lucille Clifton and Zeta Elliott. Their poems reflect rage, enduring racism, the interplay of myriad relationships, urban family events, and poignant hopes. First, Lucille Clifton, a distinguished writer, poet, and educator. She died in 2010 at the age of 74. She had twice been a finalist for the Pulitzer Prize of Poetry, and she served as the Poet Laureate of Maryland from 1979 to 1985. I will read her poem, Good Times, written in the 60s. This celebrates the family capacity for joy and fun against a background of difficult financial circumstances. Good times. My daddy has paid the rent, and the insurance man is gone, and the lights is back on, and my uncle brought his hit for $1 straight. And they is good times, good times. My mama has made bread, and grandpa has come, and everyone is drunk, and dancing in the kitchen and singing in the kitchen. Oh, these is good times, good times. Oh, children, think about the good times. The second poet that I was particularly drawn to is Zeta Elliott. Her book, Say Her Name, with illustrations by Lovis Wise, was published in 2020. She graduated from New York University in 2003 with her PhD in American Studies. She's had a varied career teaching at colleges and universities, authoring plays, novels, essays, and books for children, as well as leading mentoring programs for teen writers. Her poems reflect Black women and girls' empowerment, creativity, resilience, and poignant, fearful tenderness. The book was inspired by the Say Your Name movement launched by the African American Policy Forum in 2014. The movement seeks to bring awareness to names and stories of Black women and girls who have been victimized by police violence and to provide support to their families. I've chosen to read two poems that were heart-wrenching to me as a privileged white woman. The first is We Can't Breathe, the second, Lullaby. We can't breathe, we still seethe, we stay mad, we break bad, we rampage, we scare you, we scared too. The second poem is Lullaby. Beloved, let me sing you a lullaby. Let me wrap you in a tender embrace and rock you till you sleep. Let my flesh shield yours from bigots' bullets, clinical indifference, academic aggression, and the callous gaze that sees a monster lurking inside your hooded eyes. Let me school you, fill your mind with magic myths and truths no bars could contain. Let me build a world where you are safe to play in the park and swim in the pool and sit at your desk and sleep in your house and laugh in the street so that when you walk home from the store, you reach me alive. Thank you.